With WebLogic Server for Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, you can rapidly provision a new WebLogic Server domain along with supporting compute, network, and storage resources to host your Java enterprise applications. Your Oracle Cloud user will need access to the following services. If you are not an administrator, contact them and ask them to create the necessary policies. You must perform a few setup tasks before using WebLogic Server for Oracle Cloud Infrastructure for the first time. You must use a vault to encrypt all passwords needed to create a WebLogic domain. Create a new vault and key if you don't already have one. Create a secret in your vault for the WebLogic administrator password. Then locate and copy the identifier for this secret. From the Oracle Cloud Marketplace, choose the WebLogic Server edition that you want to run. If you already have a license for this edition, then you can choose the Bring Your Own License or BYOL application. Select the version of WebLogic you want to run and the compartment you want to use. All of the cloud resources that comprise your WebLogic domain are created as a Terraform stack in Resource Manager. Give the stack a name and also provide a prefix that will be used to name the resources in this stack. Like for any compute instances, you'll need to select a shape, public key, and availability domain for the WebLogic nodes. Set the number of nodes or managed servers in this domain as well. Next, set the credentials for the WebLogic administrator. Specify the ID of the secret in your vault. For convenience, Oracle can automatically create a new cloud network, subnets, and load balancer for the domain, or you can use your own. If you want the domain to connect to an existing autonomous VM or bare metal database in Oracle Cloud, then choose the database and enter the DB administrator credentials. If you want the domain to authenticate users from Oracle Identity Cloud Service instead of the default identity store, then you must provide some details about your IDCS environment. After creating the stack, use Resource Manager to monitor the job's progress. If you have problems, you can destroy the stack, edit your variables, and then recreate the stack. After your stack is ready, you can view its compute and network resources. You can also use the Outputs page to quickly access the WebLogic Administration Console, the sample application, or the load balancer.